I am unable to edit videos at this time because my movie maker program is obsolete, so this is just raw footage. That's why you've been seeing so much of this window lately. I kind of like it actually because it's simple. I want to say a few words about Archbishop Chrysostomos of the old calendarist group called the Synod in Resistance. This man used profanity in my presence. He took the name of Jesus Christ in vain two different times, and this is a very serious red flag that something is drastically wrong with this man on a spiritual level. I would never place my soul under obedience to a man who takes the name of the Lord in vain. This reveals something very bad about such a person, okay, who uses the Lord's name in vain. I did place my soul under him at that time because I was under, I think, mind control. But I've broken free. So this is very serious. It is demonic. It's a demonic manifestation. And I wanted to publicly expose him for this. Monastics at his monastery cuss. The Abbot Akakios cusses. And they probably do this because they probably think it's permissible because the Archbishop does it. So he's destroying these people spiritually. I also want to mention here the arrogance of this man. This is, I think, one of the most arrogant people that I've ever known. And he's deluded and deceived because he doesn't have the goods to back it up. He is not a world-leading authority on any topic of a theological nature. Not on biblical studies, not on textual studies of the Bible, not on church history, patristics, philosophy, apologetics. He is delusional. I know who the world-leading authorities are on various theological topics, and he is not among them. They would not recognize him. So he needs a dose of reality. This video is good for him. He needs a dose of reality. I am busting his bubble. And he's so arrogant. He got a PhD in psychology from Princeton, but Princeton is liberal. And I remember talking with this man in the past, and he was just too arrogant. I have corresponded with people like Gary Habermas. Gary is considered to be the world's leading authority on the evidence for the resurrection of Christ, and he's always so relaxed, kicked back, normal, healthy, and humble. You know, and sometimes I feel like, actually all the time, I feel like these Orthodox and pseudo-Orthodox bishops, pseudo referring to the old calendarist paradigm, can learn something from these heterodox scholars. They can learn humility from them. So I think that it is not spiritually healthy for a lot of men to be ordained clergy in the Orthodox world today because it goes to their head. They live in environments where fellow human beings are constantly bowing before them, kissing them and taking orders from them, and calling them the worldly royal term, Your Eminence, in the case of bishops. And I think that this augments and accentuates or creates narcissism in these people, or I think it leads to an inevitable narcissism. These people are delusional about their capabilities. And because they're not world-recognized scholars in any theological field, and because they're not clairvoyant elders, they need to be more humble, practical, biblical, and realistic in terms of how they relate to people and stop trusting their thoughts, okay? They need to come down from their delusional ivory towers and look at the real world. These are delusional ivory towers because, as I've said, they're not world-leading authorities on any topic of a theological nature. I know who the world's leading authorities are, some of them, and they would not recognize Chrysostomos as a world-recognized authority or as an authority. For example, he's not a Pauline scholar. He would not be recognized as a Pauline scholar. Pauline meaning he's not a recognized authority on the Apostle Paul. Okay, so he needs a healthy dose of reality. And this man needs to be publicly exposed for the fraud he is. People should have nothing to do with him or his pseudo-jurisdiction. I knew many years ago when I met him and his group that there was something wrong with these people, and I later got confirmation by talking to numerous people about them. And below in the description box, I will give the link to my video where I thoroughly expose St. Gregory Palamas Monastery.